Okay, so the obvious answer, okay, number one, we got to get some things out of the way first. The obvious answer is that when somebody asks you, so what is your weakness? A lot of people, they do the standard thing where they try and say a strength and they pretend it's a weakness, right? That's sort of like answer 101, right? What is your weakness? Well, I care too much and I work too hard and it's hard for me to really dial back my love for my employer, you know? That's kind of a standard amateur thing that a lot of people do. A lot of people that are doing job interviews for the first time, they might do this, okay? That's actually a pretty bad way to answer. Don't try that because number one, you can pretty much guarantee that the interviewer has encountered that before. Number two, even if they essentially have the mind of a five-year-old, they're still not fooled by that, okay? They still believe that you're not really being honest when you answer the question. And so it's just not a good answer. Don't try and dress up a strength as a weakness. When they ask you what your weakness is, you give a strength. No, bad answer. Okay, so let's get that out of the way first. Hopefully everybody probably already knows that first, okay? And that's a common thing that some people will say, right? So the other one that's sort of equally kind of basic is to say, I don't have any weaknesses, right? That's pretty popular. Tell me about your weaknesses or what's your greatest weakness? And you say, well, you know, I wish that I had any, but I just don't. I'm perfect. You know, it's really a challenge, you know, being asked questions like this when I'm just so perfect. You know, it's very embarrassing and, you know, I'm always embarrassed and we just have to get through this together. Yeah, don't say that. Okay, don't say I have no weaknesses because once again, even if the interviewer has the mind of a five-year-old, they won't be fooled by that. They won't believe you, okay? Even if hypothetically you felt you were being honest, you're like, you know, I don't really feel that I have any crushing, debilitating weaknesses that I have to constantly try and compensate for. Even if you believe that and you say that, they're not going to believe you. They're going to regard that as a hostile answer. You're being disingenuous. You're lying. And that's going to be a major red flag. Okay, so that's how this question is kind of a little bit of a trap. You have to say something that they would believe is a genuine answer to this. Okay, so that's the other thing we have to get out of the way first. Don't say, I don't have any weaknesses, and don't say a strength and pretend that that's your weakness. Okay, you know, my weakness is I'm just too good, and you know, it really is not fair to other people when they have to work with me because I just outshine them. And, you know, if they kind of stand next to me, they look so inferior. I feel sorry for them. Don't say anything like that. Even in jest, you know. The third one is to try and make a joke, right? The third thing we have to get out of the way right off the bat is to make a joke. What's your greatest weakness? Chocolate, right? Kryptonite, you know, that kind of thing. You know, not like, look, even if you think you're being clever, okay, I can guarantee you that they've heard that before, right? And they're probably going to be upset at the obvious deflection of the question in a very sort of amateur kind of way. You know, even if you said that, I don't know, maybe you could say that like, you know, just as a joke and then immediately go to a serious answer. Maybe that would be okay, but just don't do that. Okay. I guarantee you they've heard it all before. If these are professional recruiters that you're dealing with, where their job is to deal with candidates all day long, 9 to 5, every day, week after week, month after month, year after year, I guarantee you they've heard everything, okay? So don't do that either.